Hey guys, Nakul this side from Skills IELTS. For all the live updates, you can kindly click on the bell icon there. In this video, I'm going to talk about one of the most crucial and important aspects of the IELTS speaking, and that's called fluency. Well, that's one part of the story, but there's other side to it, which I'm going to explain in detail in just a while. All right, so let's try to understand the meaning of fluency. Fluency doesn't mean that you speak fast or you speak slow. Well, fluency means your ability to produce a smooth flow of speech. Let's also try to understand the factors that are associated with the fluency. So what exactly happened in the background is very simple. Let's say an English speaker, let's say a non-native speaker. What exactly the difference I'm going to show you. An English speaker, let's talk about him. He collects the thoughts, well, the brain, which has the intelligence to channelize the thoughts into his larynx. It's called a sound box, correct? He collects the thoughts, channelizes it to the larynx, and through the larynx, he will be able to produce the sound. So it's just a three-step process. The first step being, he collects the thoughts, then he channelizes, he sends the signals of speech to the larynx, and the larynx, the tongue, and the lungs through air mechanism, blah, 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 and all those stuff. Produces the sound, very simple as it is. So let's try to understand what happens at the non-English speaker side. The non-English speaker also collects the thoughts, but in his native language. Now, from the native language thoughts, he has to convert them to English. Let's say the word called pen, or any word, he'll be collecting the thoughts. He has the ability to collect the thoughts, but he collects the thoughts in his native language, and then he translates it. And once the thoughts are ready in the English language, the brain sends a signal to the larynx, and the rest of the process is similar to what an English speaker follows. So if you ask me where exactly is going wrong, the second step, for an English speaker, that extra conversion factor is not there. But for a non-English speaker, this extra conversion is there, which is called the translated, or the translation from native to English. So because of the overhead time, what exactly happens is just a fraction of a time, but that's still enough for the flow of speech to be hampered. Results in poor fluency, sounds not so good. All this happens because of that fraction of a second. So how do we overcome this? The answer is very simple. Let me ask you a simple question. How did you learn your native language? It was not by speaking. Yes, you spoke it, but before speaking, what exactly you did? You observed. And how did you observe? Through your eyes, and you listened through your ears. Most of the words you captured from people who spoke around you in their native language, you captured it, and accordingly, you generated or you developed, and accordingly you developed the ability to produce the sounds, correct? So the first part of speaking is not speaking, is listening. So the best way to improve the speaking is by listening, and you can use the media today. The technology has advanced so much that at the reach of your hand, you get access to a lot of TV serials, movies. So kindly watch it every day, at least 30-40 minutes that. So that's the first step. If you think you're struggling in speaking, always understand, the more you listen, the better you speak. So watch an English TV serial every day for at least 30-40 minutes without fail. But there is more to it. That's one way of explaining things. But there are some category of people who do not have a problem of this, translating the words from the native language to the English. But the problem they suffer is something different. They get the thoughts, but they don't know how to channelize it. Understand this is a peculiar problem, because you will not be able to understand that this is the problem you suffer from. You generate the thoughts, you're talented, imaginative, creative, good in English, everything is perfect, but you're bombarded with a lot of thoughts. When so much of thoughts are there, it's you who decides which thought you have to channelize it and speak, which you don't do that. And you give that complete control for the brain to choose. It doesn't know what is necessary and what is not necessary. So what the brain does, it just rushes all the thoughts to the tongue or the larynx. And poor tongue or the larynx doesn't have enough intelligence. And what it does, hope you know what it means, it's called overlapping sounds. What they end up doing is rushing all thoughts at once. And what happens with this is widely known. The poor tongue or the lungs or the larynx won't be able to handle all such things at once. This is what is happening when you rush things, correct? So you should learn how to channelize the things one by one. And what is the answer for that? Be calm. Go slow. Always understand, fluency doesn't mean that you speak fast. Fluency only means that you speak at a constant pace. Whether you speak slow or speak fast doesn't matter. A lot of people speak slow. At the same time, some people speak fast. Whatever the speed, be calm. Automatically, the speed will be reduced. And also one more important aspect, get a clear picture before you speak. A lot of people don't even think about it. Let's say they've got a topic and they start speaking immediately. Don't do that. If you see, some people don't have a problem at all, but a lot of people I've come across in my life, they do have a problem because they don't have a clear picture of what they speak. I'll just demonstrate what exactly I meant. So try to visualize one small sentence instead of a small phrase. So what exactly happens, they don't have a much clarity about what they speak. Let's say a person wants to eat pizza at the Domino's, but he doesn't have this picture. All the clarity he has is he wants to go. So this, he starts speaking, I want to go, then he starts thinking what he wants to do. I want to go to eat pizza at the Domino's. So this is what is happening, as opposed to this, what has to happen? Calm yourself, think. It's okay in the beginning if it takes time. So things will happen on its own. You can't enforce things to happen immediately, isn't it? So all these years you have followed something else. So if you suffer from that problem, if you really think so, then stop doing it and just calm down and think. Get a clarity of it. I want to go to that particular place, eat pizza at Domino's. Once you get a complete clarity, start speaking. That's the start of it, guys. I'm not asking you to do this in the exam, definitely not, but by the time you give the exam, you should know what are the problems you're suffering from. That's my only intention. So have a clarity of one full small sentence instead of having a clarity of a small phrase. Hope you are getting it, what exactly I meant. And also try to understand the importance of communication. What is the importance of communication? Listener has to understand, if you speak fast, it only leads to chaos, it only leads to confusion, isn't it? Speak in a way the person understands. Correct? Your primary motto is to convey the information, whatever you have in your mind. So speaking fast, being aggressive, thinking that you would get marks and all will not work. Believe me on this, if you speak fast, it only leads to confusion. So how to practice? Correct? Being fluent is not a very simple thing for a lot of people. So let's go step by step. How to practice? Take a random topic and there is no preparation. Believe me on this, if you give preparation time, again your mind starts giving excuses that without a preparation time, you'll not be able to generate a thought and all those things. So what do you do? Take a random topic, start speaking immediately, and you should speak for a minute. But there are some rules you have to abide by. I'll just demonstrate you on the same in just a while. The rule number one, you're not supposed to stop anywhere. No matter what, you cannot stop. I'm not asking you speak fast, but you are not supposed to stop. Like the way I've been speaking in this video for almost close to 10 minutes, you're not supposed to stop and keep thinking, nope. Force yourself, it is possible. It is possible. Rule number two, you should speak slow. Rule number three, you should be calm. Rule number four, you should reduce your volume while you speak. Understand the essence of the rule number four, which drives the other rules. When you reduce your volume, automatically you become calm. So the last step, when you reduce your volume, automatically the rest of the things are taken care of. So reduce your volume, that's a sign of calmness, composure. And once you're calm, automatically you end up speaking slow, and once you speak slow, automatically you end up speaking continuous, because you have enough time to understand yourself, what has to be spoken, what shouldn't be spoken, channelize it particularly, and everything goes smooth. So let me demonstrate this with this example. The question is, what do you do at your free time? Well, my answer starts something like this. Well, during my free time, I like to read a book. I'm a voracious reader. I like to read a lot of books. I follow a lot of blogs as well. And to add, I have a blog of my own as well, wherein I jot down a few of the things. The recent one I wrote was about happiness. That happiness is not an existing entity. It's a relative entity. It just is a measurement of, it's quite relative. and also I like to cook during my free time, especially to try out different salads. I try to mix the salad with, I'm running out of thoughts, but I make sure I continue. Well, I try to mix salad with dressing, we call salad dressing, made out of mayonnaise, sometimes with egg white. And I also did my free time, I hit the gym probably every day in the morning or in the evening. I go work out in the gym, drench in the sweat and do come back. And often I like to play table tennis, chess. And chess is where I believe that something that sharpens my mind. So table tennis, chess, and I also play badminton during my VR.